Hello and welcome to today's video. We're going to be taking a deep dive into Notion databases. So Notion databases are one of the core features of Notion and what's made it so popular. And sometimes they can look very confusing and overwhelming. But once you get the basics, they unlock everything in the full potential that's within Notion. So quick rundown of what you're going to learn today. We're going to be talking about databases, how they differ from normal pages, the different views within databases, relations, and a couple of pro tips towards the end. This is a very beginner-friendly tutorial, so there's no prior experience needed. So what is a Notion database? Here we are on my YouTube channel video database. This is where all of my content creation workflow takes place. So if we look within this database here, this is one view of that. And then we have the video ideas database. And then we have the board view where I can go and move things from, say, idea to published or scheduled. So as you can see, databases are at the core a way to view or a table on steroids. And then there can be multiple different ways you can view a database. So if we go into my YouTube channel kind of hub here, you can see I have a pipeline that shows the board view with my thumbnails for these videos. And then we have the videos this week view, which shows me all videos that I've uploaded or scheduled for this week. So again, this is a page with databases inline or kind of embedded in the page. And this is the actual core database that everything's being run off of. So let's go ahead and start a new page and show you exactly everything you're going to need to know to get up and running with a database. So how do we create a database? In order to create a new page in Notion, all you would do is this little pencil icon here, go to create new page. This gives us a page. Now, pages are different than databases. So we'll create a page that says database views right here. And then within that page, we can then do a slash like this here. And this brings up all of the options that Notion has available to us. We'll just type in database after that. And then we can have a few different options. We have the database inline or the database full page. So database inline will add a new inline or embedded database to the current page. A database full page will add a new database as a sub page. So what we want to do is we want to add this as an inline or embedded into this page so we don't create a new page. So what I want to do here is I want to create this as an inline database within the current page that we've already created. Now, once you've done that, it's going to automatically show the view as table view. So if you click on table here, you can see that we can go to edit view and we have all kinds of different layouts here, table, board, timeline, etc. These can change the way that the database is viewed. But right now, let's just build our database out, and then we'll talk about views in a minute. So the first thing that you want to do is start adding properties to your database. So think of properties as if you have a table in Excel or Google Sheets, all of the different rows and columns will have different properties. So you see, the initial property automatically added is your name. And then if we want to add properties, we go here where the addition symbol is next to name and go to the addition symbol here. And that brings up the different properties. Let's say we want to add a property of, say, created time. So we'll click on created time. That's going to be whenever a new thing's added to the database, the created time will come up. So if we add a new page in the database like cats here, you can see the created time was today's date, the exact time right here. And the beauty of this is that you don't have to show this. If you don't want to see it in the view, but you want it to be in each page, you can just click on that there and you can see hide in view. Now, when you click or open up a page within the database, the created time is here, May 12th, 2025, 10:19 a.m., but it's not showing up in the view and taking up space on things that you may want to see or not see within the database view. So again, to add more properties, we just go here and we can click these three dots under properties. We can click on properties and right here under the properties tab, we can add all of our properties. So go to new property and let's say we want to add a select or multi-select options. So for this type of property, which is our select property here, you can only select one of the options that you add. So for like our animal database, we'll just add a description here and the options will be spiky, furry, fluffy, different ways to describe our animals. And then now when we go to description here, we can click in that option there and you can see all of our different options are available. So for cats, we're going to add furry, just like that there. Now, if you wanted to under description, if you made a mistake, you can go here and change it to fluffy or whatever you want to change it to. If we click into our descriptions like so, you can see any of our options at any time. We can select the three little horizontal dots here and we can rename that. We can give it a different color and we can even delete that said option if we want to, just like so. So again, we go back to these three dots, we go to properties and we start adding other properties. And next, we're going to add a number property. So we're going to click into number property here. And with the number property, we're going to go ahead and rename that rating like so. You can rename any property from the edit property options here. And it's going to be a number type of property. And under number format, we just want it to be a number. But if you wanted to, it could be a percentage. It can be a currency. All of these things will be under number formatting. And then for decimal places, you can add if you want to add decimal places. And then you want to show it as either an individual number, a bar, or a ring. We're going to go ahead and show this as a bar. Our bar color is going to be green, and we're going to divide this by 10. So we're going to rate our animals on a 1 to 10 scale of how much we like them, and we are going to show the number. So we're going to click that there. Now, we're going to say that we like cats at 8 out of 10. So if we type in an 8 there under our rating and click off, you can see it's going to give us the bar from 8 to 10, and it's going to give us a visual view of that number. So again, it's very powerful, the different properties that you can add. Now, if you ever wanted to, we could click and hold here in our database view, click and hold a property and drag them left to right to put them where we want them in the table. So if we want our rating to be at the very beginning, we can click and drag that to be at the very beginning. And then one thing that I failed to mention is that you can name your table. So right now, the table's called New Table. But if you wanted to, you could click the three dots next to the name and you could go to Hide Database Title. That'll remove it from the database altogether. And then if you wanted to, you could just use the table here or the view and you could rename that view to be just whatever you wanted it to be. And that could act as your title of that database like so. But it will not look as good as the normal database titles. Something else I wanted to show you is under these multi-select options here in the database, like for this one for snakes, if we click in here and we're like, well, they're not spiky, furry, or fluffy, we can add something. So we can add, say, slimy and hit enter, and that's going to add that option as you go. So if you don't have all the descriptors or all the selects that you want to add, you can always add them at a later date. Once you've started adding your properties and you start filling out your database, you're going to start seeing the beauty of what you can do with databases. So because this is an inline view here, and we've kind of got some data in the database, we can now begin to sort and filter out the things that we want to see in specific pages. So let's say we wanted to go ahead and sort them by least to most as far as like, hey, we want the animals that we like the least at the top and the ones we like the most at the bottom. We can click on the rating property here and we can sort by ascending or descending. So if we go to ascending, you can see it's going to give us that rating from least to most. And then you can just see the animals in kind of a view here in the database. Another thing we can do is we can filter. So if we go to our filter options, which are these three lines here, we can go to filter, and we want to filter by, let's say, the description of these animals. And we only want to see the ones that are furry or fluffy. We select those two options there, and we go ahead and click off. That will then give us a filter that's still sorting from least to greatest, and it's giving us a filter of these options in our description property. If you ever want to remove a filter or a sort, you can go up here, click on the sort options like so, and you can just remove it by hitting the X there. Same thing for filters. Click on filters, go to where the applied filters are, and then you just go ahead and hit the X, and that will remove that filter just like so. Next, I want to show you about adding a specific property to add or upload a file to the database entries. So if we go here under properties and add a files and media option, we're going to go ahead and rename this pictures, because we're going to upload pictures of all of these animals. And then what we want to do is we don't really want this to be shown in our table view here. So we'll click on that property and we'll go to hide in view. And now when we go into the individual entry, like say for cats here, we'll see an option that says pictures with the empty here. We click into empty and then we go to choose a file. Now we're able to go select a file on our computer, double click and hit open. And now that image will be attached to that entry here within our database. I also wanted to show you that you could customize the way that properties look once you're in an entry in a database. So once we've added the pictures here or the images, we can click and hold that property and drag it up or down to put it in order of how we want to see all of our properties. So now we can go to any page within Notion, go to /, and go to database inline, click that there. Now what we can do is we can search for the database that we just created. So right here, we can go to any page in Notion, select that there. It's going to bring up a view of that database, and you're going to see the arrow, meaning that this is a view and not the actual page like this one above here is the actual raw database page. So you want to create your database page, and then you'll have different views. So now we're going to do a different view, and we're going to go to Edit View, and we're going to go to Layout. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go to Gallery. So we're going to go to Gallery View here. And this is a completely different view than the table view up above. And we want to basically, we want the card size to be medium here. We want to go ahead and the card preview, we want that to be pictures. So you can see now the pictures are coming up as our preview to give this a much cleaner and fun, kind of more fun way to look at our database. And then if you wanted to, you could change the card size to small, you could change the card size to large, whatever you wanted to change it to here. And then you can even give the option, I want to open my pages in center or side peek. I'm going to choose side peek for this one. And as you can see, here's our same database, but it is in a gallery view. Now, I could have done this up here by clicking add a new view to the current database, but I just wanted to show you that you could do this within any page in your Notion as you can link to existing databases. Now, one last thing that I wanted to show you here is under properties, if we go up here and go to properties, we're able to see the different properties that we add. So go to new property. One of the most powerful properties in Notion is our relation property. If we go to relation here, this will allow us to link multiple databases together. So as you can see for me, if I go to my YouTube channel database here, I have my YouTube channel database connected. So if I open up this one here, I have it connected to other databases. So right here, I have it connected to a YouTube Shorts database. So if I click on empty here, I can add and connect shorts that are part of a different database. So the power of that is that you're now able to have multiple databases that are interlinking together to allow you to see different properties and different descriptors within multiple databases. Next, I want to show you templates. So templates allow you to create one template that will hopefully save you time when you're adding new entries to a database. So if we go up here to our database and we go to the dropdown next to new, I want to go to new template. This will allow us to go ahead and add things that will come up every time we add a new entry in the database. So now if I go here at the very top, and it's in that database that we're working on, we can even add icons. So we can go ahead and add some icons to this. So we'll go ahead and add this little monkey icon, and we'll even add a cover. So we'll add a little color cover like this here. And if you wanted to, you could go to change cover to change the color or look of said cover. And then you can see where it says repeat. You can even add these as repeatable entries. So if you're doing like a daily journal, you can repeat this every day and it'll add your new journal at the beginning of each and every day. Same goes for weekday, week, and you can do any cadence that you want. Once you've done that, you go ahead and click off and that will create that template. Now, when we hit the drop-down menu, you can see here's our animal name template. And if we go ahead and click the dots right here, we can set this as default. We'll do for all views in this database. And then when we go to new, it'll automatically create a new entry that goes ahead and fills in all of the different things that, you know, we have within that, you know, entry. So you can see I can add a new entry, go here, and we are good to go. Now you can see it adds that little icon or emoji, whatever you want. So now anytime you go and create a new entry in the database, it's going to pop that custom template that we just created as default in our database. The last thing I want to talk about is syncing and sharing databases in Notion. So what you'd want to do is go to the database actual page, not different views, but the actual page. And once you're here, you want to go to the right-hand corner where you see share, and then you're able to invite people via their email address. You can type in email addresses like so and go to invite, and that will invite them to that specific database on Notion where they'll have that on their sidebar as a database. You can copy the link, put it out there to the public via a message or whatever, and it will allow people to click the link and join and see and view the actual database that you're sending out. Also, when you're sharing, you can click the drop-down menu. All the people that you invite, you can give them either full access, only ability to edit, They can only comment or they can only view, or you can even remove those people by clicking on remove here. And then the last thing, if they wanted to, they could go to comments and they could comment on the database. Last thing, if you wanted to do, you could actually publish by going to publish and click publish, and it'll give this a custom URL for that database to be sent out to only be viewed on the web if that's something that you wanted to do. Couple of pro tips. Don't try to build it all at once. Work on it. It's much easier to start it and then kind of improve it as you go. Start with a single database like a task manager or an idea tracker, and then you can kind of expand into relating databases, and then use existing templates from Notion's template gallery. So if you wanted to, you can see here that over on the sidebar on Notion, it's got an option that says templates. If you go to templates here, you'll see that, hey, here's a to-do list database. If we click on this one here, it will automatically add this little database of to-dos into our Notion board automatically, which is a really cool thing. So use that if you want. So that's it. That's everything that you need to know as a beginner about Notion databases. If you have any further questions, put them in the comment section. I will get to those as soon as I can. Hopefully this was helpful. If it was, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video.